friends. I'm Rohan Jejekar. I am before you to share my views about electronic vehicles, a push of UN government into the budget, its impacts and challenges. Let's discuss. Its impacts. That through promoting electronic vehicles in this budget, India can become a leader of manufacturers of electronic vehicles in the world. And India can also reduce the pollution as it is zero emission vehicles. And as the report of International Energy Agency in 2018, China has become the home of half of electric vehicles in the world, followed by European countries, USA, etc. These countries are putting forward their ideas on or promoting electronic vehicles to reduce pollution and regain their economy. China is going to sell 4.6 million of electronic vehicles by 2020, as China will become the largest electronic vehicles manufacturer in the world. In India, it will reduce the usage of limited resources by the government and dependency on it. In the developed countries, they have given subsidies to buy electronic vehicles from 20 to 25% of 25% to gain electric mobility, as to create an electric vehicle ecosystem. So India should also gain or promote electric vehicles to gain this electric mobility. Niti Aayog has declared that India will gain electric mobilities by 2025 when the companies have invested their time in it. Their challenges. If Union government push electronic vehicles in the budget, it can make a great loss to the companies that invested in India. That means in 2018, the companies have a great loss if India is implementing electronic vehicles, and immediately it will give a great loss to them. In India, Hyundai, except Hyundai Limited India, others doesn't have introduced electronic vehicles in India. In Hyundai Limited, they have introduced the vehicle Kona. In its price is 25,30,000, as it's from the price 25,30,000, the 40% of that cost is on its batteries. That's much complicated is that vehicle. It is not an affordable to an normal person, and it can cause a great economy loss to India. By implement electronic vehicles, India should implement infrastructures as charging points, manufacturers, etc. This also need so much money, but India doesn't have as much money for to implement it. As we can, another option is to cut BS4 to BS6. It's a limited solution that to reduce pollution. We can gear up to BS4 to BS6, as it can reduce pollution than BS4. Electronic vehicles is a good step to reduce pollution, but India doesn't have enough policy to buy it. As FAME India is a policy, but it doesn't give an enough satisfaction for the normal persons at personal transport facilities. And electronic vehicles may be the future, but today the companies cannot afford it, and it will give a great loss to them. And the government of India have reduced ₹50,000 for the price, but this is not enough for a normal person, as though it is a complicated technology and it cannot be affordable to a normal person. And so the way forward is, I said that BS, we can gear up to BS6. It is a good solution to reduce pollution. And to implement electronic vehicles in India to reduce pollution, or giving more importance to the development, India should implement infrastructures for it and perfect charging points and other facilities and service sectors, etc. So this is a complicated process for India to implement it now.